brothers and sisters. This is very great month. Allah Azza wa Jal gave it to us. Allah Azza wa Jal gifted us with this great month. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال أبو هريرة said that رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said that أتاكم رمضان شهر مبارك. You have a blessing month. You have very great month. You have very beautiful month. Allah Azza wa Jal ask you to fast. In this month, the gate of the heaven open. And if can anyone imagine the meaning and how it's great when the gate of the heaven open. It is very great gift from Allah Azza wa Jal. And the people who are standing all the year at the gate of the heaven to open. What that mean? That mean acceptance to your dua. What that mean? That mean acceptance to your request. Every one of us has a lot of difficulties in his life. And this is what I feel and what I touch when the people contact me. There are a lot of many things of disease, of difficulties, of problem in the work. But now it is the time. The gate of the heaven is open and the gate of hell is closed. And also the marada of shayateen are stopped. The marada of shayateen are stopped. And everyone fast this month as Allah ask him to fast for Allah, for nothing else. Allah will forgive his sins. But the question and the great question, what is the reason of fasting? And we have to ask us about this. Why we do this? Stop eating, stop drinking, so everything. Why we do this? And we need an answer. It is for prayer Taraweeh. How the people busy? It's 20 or 8 or Juz'a or this mosque or God. What should we eat in this month? What is the main reason of this month? Allah Azza wa Jal, who asked us to fast, Allah Azza wa Jal will answer us in the ayah 183 in Surah Al-Baqarah when he said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَبَّيْكَ اللَّهُمَّ لَبَّيْكَ كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Oh believer, oh who believe, I ask you to fast as I ask the nations before you, all the people before you to fast. But what is the reason? May you become righteous. Righteous. At-taqwa. You were from the righteous, from al-muttaqin. And I would like to be honest with you that most of the translation to the Quran or tafsir in English, they said taqwa, fear Allah. And I want to say something. Fearing Allah is a part from at-taqwa. And at-taqwa has another meaning. At-taqwa is to respond to Allah Azza wa Jal. To respond with love. To respond with believe that what Allah Azza wa Jal sent to you is the best. What Allah Azza wa Jal ask you to do is the best in your life. What Allah Azza wa Jal ask you not to do is for your benefit. It is for your benefit. This is the meaning of taqwa. This is the meaning of taqwa. And for this reason, Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned this word and the other word coming from this word in more than 240 positions in the Quran. And this is give us an idea how much taqwa is important and how much the Quran care about at-taqwa and how at-taqwa is the millstone of our religion. It is the foundation of our religion. It includes all the rules, all the sharia law. Everything we need is included in at-taqwa. And at-taqwa, it is the essential and it is the foundation for every religion Allah Azza wa Jal send to the people on this earth. And it is the testament. It is the will of every prophet to his people. Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned in Surah An-Nisa, Ayah 131, وَلَقَدْ وَصَّيْنَا الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ وَإِيَّاكُمْ أَنِ اتَّقُونَ. We recommend, we testament to the people of the book before you, and we recommended you what? أَنِ اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. أَنِ اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. Protect yourself from the anger of Allah. Protect yourself from going to heal, protect yourself from any bad things. How can I do this? How can I do this? I can do this by understanding the meaning of taqwa. There is 81 place Allah order us to be from al-muttaqin. And Allah order us to care about al-taqwa. And he do it in different way. Ya ayyuhal nas. Ya ayyuhal nas. Oh people. And sometimes, ya ayyuhal ladhina aman. Oh who believe. And sometimes he order also his prophet. Also his prophet. And this is in Surah Al-Ahzab, ayah number 1. When he said, ya ayyuhal nabi. Oh prophet, ittaqillah. الله أكبر الله أكبر أوه بروفيت يا أيها النبي اتق الله ولا تطيع الكافرين والمنافقين إن الله كان عليما حكيما أوه بروفيت اتق الله take everything Allah asks you to take and do everything Allah asks you to do and don't do everything Allah asks you not to do and don't obey the rejecter and the hypocrites يا أيها النبي اتق الله ولا تطيع الكافرين والمنافقين don't obey the rejecter don't obey the hypocrites إن الله كان عليما حكيما of course indeed Allah is the all knowing Allah is the all wise so our trip inshallah in this month will be with التقوى with التقوى what did you achieve of the curriculum of التقوى in your Ramadan how much you achieve there is 81 order from Allah what did you do with this order oh alhamdulillah this Ramadan I achieved 5 This Ramadan, I achieved 10. If you send someone to work to bring money, after month, after year, you ask him, how much you achieve? He said, 10,000. Okay, you send your student to school this year in the first grade, next year in the second grade, third year, and so on. So, and this is the way of life in everything in our life. But Allah asks us to fast, to achieve at-taqwa. How much we achieve? There is no answer. There is no answer because we didn't put our real plan according to the Quran because there is no teacher help us to achieve what Allah Azza wa Jal asks us to achieve. At-taqwa is the gate to get many important things. It is the gate to get the real knowledge. It is the gate to be from those who Allah said about them, Ulul Albab. It is the gate to be from Al-Muhsineen. It is the gate to achieve the good akhirah. It is the milestone and it is the reason of all al-ibadat. The fasting is ibadah and the other ibadat, the goal of it is to get progress in the subject of at-taqwa. Of course, at-taqwa is not subject. Just I give this word to at-taqwa is the last grade. It is the last grade. When someone graduates from the university, there are many subjects and he study many things. But at the end, we told him, okay, your result is 3.8, 4.1 or something like this. What is this is the last result. And at-taqwa is the last result of all your work. For this reason, Allah Azza wa Jal told us, Inna akramakum inda Allahi atqakum. The best of you is the best in taqwa, is the best in the result. The most one closer to apply the real sunnah of Rasulullah, the one who get the highest result in at-taqwa. Inshallah, in this Ramadan, we will go through at-taqwa. We will see what we already achieve and we will see what we need to achieve and to put in our life that every Ramadan we will evaluate ourselves according to at-taqwa. كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. We ask you to fast as we ask the people before you to fast, to achieve, to get progress, to get more in at-taqwa. May Allah Azza wa Jal make this month the month of forgiveness and the month that Allah free our neck from the hell a month that Allah donate us and gift us his satisfaction, his love, his mercy, his protection. And in reality, we need all of these. Ya ayyuhal nas. Oh people, ittaqu rabbakum. Take care of attaqwa. Protect yourself from the anger of Allah. Inna zalzalata sa'ati shay'un azim. The earthquake of the hour is something very great. May Allah give you khair and afia. May Allah accept from all of you. May Allah help us to understand attaqwa in the way he satisfied with, in the way he want us to understand this. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. الفاتحة. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على سيدنا محمد وعلى جميع إخوته من الأنبياء والمرسلين. يا رب العالمين، يا رجاء السائلين، يا غياث المستغيثين، يا رب يا رب، إنا وقفنا ببابك ضعفاء مساكين. يا رب إنا وقفنا ببابك نرجو رحمتك. يا رب إنا وقفنا ببابك نرجو مغفرتك. يا رب إنا وقفنا ببابك نرجو أن تعتق رقابنا ورقاب أبنائنا ورقاب أحبابنا من النيران. يا رب العالمين، يا رجاء السائلين، يا غياث المستغيثين، يا أمان الخائفين، يا أمل المتحيرين، إليك نشكو ضعف قوتنا وقلة حيلتنا وهواننا عن الناس. يا أرحم الراحمين، يا أكرم الأكرمين، إلى من تكلنا؟ إلى عدو يتجهمنا أم إلى قريب لا يهتم لأمرنا؟ لك العتبى حتى ترضى، لك العتبى حتى ترضى، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. يا رب يا رب، اجعلنا من المتقين. يا رب اجعلنا من الذين فهموا أحكامك وفهموا أوامرك وطبقوها على الشكل الذي يرضيك عنا يا أرحم الراحمين. يا رب سلمنا لرمضان، وسلم رمضان لنا، وتسلمه منا متقبلا، وأعنا فيه على الصيام، وأعنا فيه على القيام، وأعنا فيه على غض البصر، وأعنا به على حفظ اللسان، وأعنا به على أن نصوم على الشكل الذي يرضيك عنا يا أكرم الأكرمين، يا أرحم الراحمين، يا رجاء السائلين، يا غياث المستغيثين. وقفنا ببابك فلا تردنا خائبين. يا رب وقفنا ببابك فلا تردنا من فسيح جنابك. ثبتنا على طاعتك، ثبتنا على فهم أحكامك، ثبتنا على فهم دينك. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. إلى شرف النبي وأرواح المؤمنين وإلى روح من سبقنا من آبائنا وأمهاتنا وأرحامنا ومشايخنا وأساتذتنا وتلامذتنا إلى دار البقاء. الفاتحة.